Hello and welcome to the tutorial on Excel Solver. In this video, I will solve an example of the shortest path problem. So grab a mug of coffee and let us get started. Consider the network you are seeing on your screen. We want to find the shortest path between node O and F. I will call node O as the start point and node F as the destination. The distance between each one of the nodes is written close to each edge. Notice that the network is undirected, which means that it is possible to move in both directions on each edge. The mathematical formulation is written on the right-hand side of the screen, and the objective is to minimize the total distance. Let's start writing the data in the first tableau. We are going to start by writing the edges on columns B and C, and the distances on column E. The first edge starts at node O and goes to node A with a distance of 7. The second edge starts at node O and goes to C with a distance of 10. Let's write the edges linked to node A. We have edges AO, AB, and AD. However, AO returns to the start point, so we do not include it in the table. The same thing will happen with edge OC. Since it returns to the depot, we are not going to add it to the table. Let me fill in the rest of the table. Alright, now we should start writing the constraints. Start by typing all the nodes in column G. Let's write the right-hand side. The start node should have a right-hand side of 1, so type 1 in cell J3. The destination's right-hand side is negative 1. On cell J9, type negative 1. The other nodes will have a right-hand side of 0. As written in the model, the constraints have an equality side, so type equal in the constraints in column I. Now, we should write the left-hand side of the constraints. As written in the model, we should consider the flow balance, which means that the flow out minus the flow in should be equal to BJ. Let's write the first sum. Type equal sum if. This function requires three criteria: range, criteria, and sum range. The range is going to be column B. Select B3 up to B18. And press F4 to add the dollar sign and fix this column. Then press comma and select node O in cell G3. The last criteria to be added is the column of the decision variables, the light gray cells. Press F4 to fix these cells as well. Let's add the second sum in the same cell. Type minus sum if parenthesis. The three criteria now will be column C from cell C3 to C18. These cells should be fixed by adding the dollar sign or pressing cell F4. Then select node O, cell G3, and finally select and fix the decision variables. Click on the small green square at the bottom right corner of the cell and drag it down. Now, go to the orange cell. This is where the objective function will be placed, and we should calculate the sum product of the decision variables and the distances. Type equal sum product D3 up to D18, comma E3 up to E18. Now, we are ready to solve the model. Go to the Data tab at the bar on top and open Excel Solver. Choose the orange cell as the objective function. Then, choose min to indicate that this is a minimization problem. After that, select the light gray cells D3 to D18 as the decision variables. Press the button Add to start adding the constraints. On the first space, select the left-hand side H3 to H9. Then, choose the equality sign and select the right-hand side J3 to J9. Press OK to add the constraint. Check the box Make unconstrained variables non-negative and choose Simplex LP as the solving method. Press Solve and then OK. The decision variables with a value of 1 are OA, AD, and DF, so the shortest path is OADF with a total distance of 15. I hope that this tutorial clarified how you can solve the shortest path problem using Excel Solver. Stay tuned to our upcoming tutorials.